Let's get the pink elephant out of the room.
Let's do it.
Because when I said Brian McKnight, I saw my girlfriend Mashari go, right. And then I said Junior, and she was like, I'm curious, yeah. What is this about? So, obviously, you are Brian McKnight Jr.,
Son of Brian McKnight. Son of the legend, Brian McKnight Jr., R&B crooner. Yeah.
Yeah.
Also, though, son of Julie McKnight, also a legend, my mama. I never leave her out of the equation.
I love it.
She's doing her thing.
Yeah.
So, yeah. But,
So how does that work being, I'm talking about your mama right now.
Yeah.
Like, how does that work being able to give your mother just as much props as your father?
Oh, my gosh. It makes me the happiest. You know what I mean? My mom put her dreams and her career on the back burner to raise my brother and I. And over the last 7 to 10 years, she's really made her research. And she's got 3 or 4 number one hit songs herself in the house music spectrum. And she's touring. I think she's in Italy right now playing some festival. And every other day she's calling me and my brother like, I'm flying here, I'm flying there. And it fills me with so much joy because she's smiling, she's happy, she's looking good, she's doing her thing. Her husband is her bodyguard, so they're flying all over. And I'm just like, Ma, do it.
So it's inevitable that you were going to be in the music business. Your mother is a musician, your father is a musician.
It was inevitable to me.
Ah.
I don't think it was as inevitable to my dad.
Mm-hmm.
My mom knew it was either going to be this or basketball. But for me, you know, since I was about 6 or 7, there was no doubt in my mind I wanted to be one of the biggest singer-songwriters, I think, of all time.
Do you have any balling skills?
I do.
Okay.
I really
sometimes
do.
Sometimes people just assume tall people can ball, and some of y'all
No. I can really go.
You can really go?
Yeah, I can really go. Okay. It really is the only thing that I brag about. Most people don't really know that I even do music until recently because I'm kind of soft-spoken about it, but you step on the court with me, you'll know exactly.
I've actually seen you do background for your father.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we toured for almost 7 or 8 years. You know, we went everywhere. We got to do the anthem at a couple special occasions, and that was really prolific for us. But, yeah, we were always either singing background or kicking them off stage and doing our own thing.
I actually saw you and I think your brother doing a song together.
Oh, yeah.
So is like, will you all be a duet like Casey and JoJo? Or?
Oh, without a doubt. I call us the new Outkast all the time. You know, he's an incredible singer, songwriter, guitar player, savant himself. And we are actually a rock band as well. We go by Broken Robots, and the brunt of our success has really come from that. Overseas, you know, we were fortunate enough to have a few songs really get out there and make it. And we're definitely going to be putting that back out there very soon, so I'm excited about that.
So I have to ask, because you probably don't know, I actually do follow you and your brother.
I've been
following y'all on Instagram, so I have to ask, are things good with you and your father? Because you guys put out some bad stuff on Brian McKnight. He came back and said, look, I've been taking care of my kids all of my life, and they're just mad right now. Were you just mad right now, or what's the deal?
You know, for me, I guess even when it comes to the post, I personally didn't expect it to blow up because it's definitely not my first time ever saying anything about my father online. And I guess what I tell everyone now is I'm definitely not the first son to have a dispute with his dad.
Right.
I think the only difference is my dad happens to be Brian McKnight. And since everyone has their own sense of who he is because he's this love song writer and he's this incredible legend that we all know, it's kind of easy to build a false sense of, oh, I know who you are.
I can feel that, yeah.
I'm going to side with you.
Yeah, because we don't know Brian McKnight like you know Brian McKnight.
Yeah,
that's
true. He's my dad, you know, and it's not that I regret anything because I believe it's going to begin a bigger talk.
But do you regret, like, making it public that you were having issues with your father?
Not at all. You figure I write about this in my music. Mm-hmm. You know, I write books about this. I want to be a son of someone like that. That can finally have a platform to tell people how we feel.
But have you together, the two of you, have you talked face to face and made it all good?
We've tried.
So it's not all good.
That. You know, there's some things that need to be worked out.
Right.
And I just think it's one of those things where you figure I'm 30 now, and it's going to be more than a father-son. It's a man talk. I'm a father myself.
That's good.
You know,
right?
And it's deeper than me just needing to talk to my dad. No, we need to settle some things as men. And I feel like, you know, that's where I'm at. And it's nothing ill. You know, I love my dad. He's still my favorite artist. I still listen to him. My girlfriend all the time is like, wow, I can't believe that you still even, you know, promote your father. I'm like, it's my dad. You know, I can't, we'll never get away. I look like him, sound like him, You know, it's like
you do. You look like you sound like. If you even get away have mannerisms, of Brian
right?
McKnight.
You know, he's in me, and I guess for me, even after all this, in the course of everything I've been through, just this last few months, I've realized, you know, we're all growing, man. We're all evolving, and I think a lot of children don't necessarily, you know, assess for the fact that our parents have lives too. They have trauma. They have things they've gone through, childhoods that we don't know nothing about. So that can get lost too from the connection of father and son as well. And I really want to be a role model and kind of someone to generate the talks where we can bridge that gap and just figure out where those disconnects come from.
There was one thing I wanted to know that people place so much judgment on, and I hope you can kind of clear the water on this for me, Brian. A lot of people judged the fact that maybe he didn't take care of his children because you all said he didn't. Has Brian McKnight supported his sons financially for the last 30 years?
Financially? Well, I mean, what do you say?
Because
last
you're
30,
30 now. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Like,
he
should have dropped your ass off at 18, 19, 20.
He did. No, okay. he did.
Uh-huh.
Oh, he definitely did.
Right.
So, and I even knew that before all this, that's knowing my dad, was going to be his defense. You throw money into the pot, especially with someone that everyone knows has money, it's going to be pretty hard to not believe what he's saying.
Got
but
it.
I tell you this, me and my brother have supported ourselves and have taken care of ourselves for the last decade. We toured with him for 7 years now. That was 15 to 21 for me, so that's 13 to 20 for my brother, and we were making our own money outside of even him, and see all those kinds of things kind of get lost in, I was taking care of them. But child support ain't taking care of your children.
Okay.
And that's the biggest thing I want to tell people. You know, were we living in my dad's house? Sure. Did we get kicked out and have to go fend for ourselves? Oh yeah, and did we do that? I feel like pretty well.
Well, I think you're taking care of yourself pretty well. You're on the Tammi Mack Late Show, and I want to hear another song.